Clover cheese is for those who love life, where everything falls into place and melts away our cares. Clover, for the love of cheese.
Made with love by Clover.
Welcome back to Afternoon Express, where we are making delicious pillow cheesy bao buns, all Asian inspired. Now, simply SMS the keyword Clover to 33650 to get this recipe. SMSs are charged at 1.50 and free SMSs do not apply. Ladies, this seems to be coming together quite well. I mean, this is definitely Asian inspired esque, and it seems to be really, really good. Your dough has come together quite nicely.
Yes.
So, what are you up to now?
What I'm going to need you to help me with actually is if you can start with our three ingredient barbecue sauce. It's absolutely easy. Anyone can do this. It's the best thing.
Stunning. So what ingredients do we have here to put this together?
We have some tomato sauce,
okay,
some brown sugar, and some Worcester sauce. So
oh,
you can pop anything in. It doesn't matter in which order. Let's just start with a little bit of oil first. It's that ramekin over there that you've got.
No problem.
A little bit of oil.
Okay.
And then we also want to start this on quite a low to medium heat, so about three or four.
Should be good.
Three or four.
Oil's in, we're gonna wait for that to heat up. Don't worry, you can continue.
Yes,
I don't
wanna
take you away from your station because at the end of the show, I'm trying to eat and if the food is not ready, we're beefing.
Don't worry.
Speaking about beef, on the vegetarian side, how's it going, Dumi?
It's going well. I'm gonna ask Berita to actually get started for me with the mushrooms. She's gonna fry up our mushrooms for us once the butter's melted over there. And then I'm also gonna get started with our buns as well that we're gonna fill. So I'm just rolling out the dough as well on my side.
Okay, perfect. In terms of technique, Chef Dumi, putting these fillings together, how does timing play a role?
Luckily, with this kind of recipe, you don't necessarily need to time anything. It's basically just about being present in the kitchen.
Mm.
It's one of the few recipes where you, once you've done all the different ingredients, you don't actually have to stand over the pot. You just put on a timer. Like, for instance, the actual dough itself, it only needs about 8 minutes to cook. So if you've got all the other ingredients sorted, all the other elements of your dish sorted, then you don't even need to worry about, oh my gosh, I need to stand over my pot and I need to wash. Watch it. But one thing I do need to mention, like for instance, I'm rolling out the dough now. I've noticed that people always ask me, like, how do I get that perfect circle or that perfect round when I roll my dough? The technique for that is to make sure that, for instance, let me show you now, I'm rolling at the one side. And then once you've done that, when you turn it over, you basically turn it clockwise so that it turns to a different angle. So you don't just flip it over like this. When you turn it over, you keep going around with it. You just keep going around with it so that you get a perfect circle. So I'm going to roll it out now. It obviously elongates this side. And then what I do is when I flip it over, it becomes lengthwise. And now when I roll it out again, instead of being a long log, it becomes a nice round circle. So just keep doing that and then it stays a full circle the entire time.
I know I'm not the only one who felt that. I mean, Berita, we had no clue that we were doing it wrong this entire time. I love that. So we turn it clockwise, we keep rolling it out, flipping,
Yes.
Love that. Okay, stunning. So the mushrooms are already on the pan. This barbecue sauce is coming together quite well. All we put in here is tomato sauce, brown sugar, and Worcester sauce, and voila, perfect barbecue sauce.
And then let's heat up this big pan over here so we can start with the bacon for our bacon filling.
Okay. Yeah, it seems hot enough. Oh, very hot.
Yeah. So then you just lay the strips down nicely, one by one, evenly, preferably not on top of each other so that everything cooks evenly and cooks at the same time.
Ah, nice. Okay.
Great.
I can already hear that sizzling there. This sounds really good. Ah, nihlega and there. What am I missing out on?
No, I think this is a secret we'll keep to ourselves, hey? I don't want to embarrass anyone.
Beautiful, beautiful.
But no, I'm just helping her out with the peppers. The one thing I have noticed that is people tend to worry about using hands in the kitchen. As long as your hands have been sanitized correctly, you don't have to worry about that.
Okay.
Just need to make sure they stay clean, and then you can actually use them each time. Just make sure that they've been cleaned and just... Because it's easier because you can feel the food.
Yeah.
The one thing with cooking is that it's harder to use utensils because you tend to not always know whether it's cooked enough, whether it's rolled out enough, and stuff like that. So that's what we're doing here. We're using our hands to make sure that we feel the food, not only with our tongues, but also with our hands.
Love that. And you know, sanitation is very key,
especially because
right now everyone is having health scares and it's flu season. So if not for the food, just for yourself, make sure you're washing your hands, you're sanitizing your hands, and making sure that everything is kept clean and pristine in the kitchen.
Correct.
Okay, love that. Chef Chasline, how's it going that side? What do you have?
Very good. So what I'm working on now is just a bit of a slaw to go with our delicious bao buns. It's a nice side. Just a bit of crunch, something fresh. So what I'm adding to that is a little bit of spring onion, some carrots, and then some shredded red cabbage with a little bit of lemon juice.
Beautiful.
Super
so do we at least have half a bao bun almost ready to go in? Because I want to see the incredible technique. Because, I mean, I've seen this being used when people are creating dim sum in certain restaurants. So this is the same kind of utensils that we're going to be using for our bao bun.
Basically, yes. So I'm going to try and roll out one for us now. Let me just put our bowl over here. So I'm going to spoon in a bit of the filling into our dough. So we've rolled it out. You don't want it to be too thick, but you also don't want it to be too thin, because if it's too thin, it literally is going to tear. So you want to keep it a little bit thick. I'm going to make this bun, but not with the barbecue, just with the cheese. For some of us that enjoy our cheese.
I love my cheese.
And then the aim is to try and pull the top of it so that you try and close it together. So we're just making like a little bun and then we're circling it together. And then what we do at the end, we just pinch it at the top and it becomes like a nice little parcel. I actually found out that bao actually means treasure. So maybe that's why it's a little parcel. It's hidden in here. When you find it, you feel like you found a bit of a treasure.
That's so cute. Well, I know the fillings are definitely worth a whole lot in my book because they're filling, they're nutritious, and they're soothing, they're comforting. So this meal, it's good for lunch, good for dinner, basically all of.
Yes. It's an all-day dinner.
Should that be ready?
Yeah.
Okay,
perfect.
Oh,
that's beautiful.
Yeah, I'm killing the bacon, killing the spring onion. Who knows what she's doing? Remember to SMS the keyword Clover to 33650 to get this recipe sent to your device. But just in case you missed any of the steps, here's a quick recap on our bao buns.
Made with love by Clover.
Everything is coming together really nicely in the kitchen here. Our fillings for our bao buns are quite well underway. The bacon is looking good. The cheese and the mushrooms are coming together perfectly. Definitely looking forward to enjoying this at the end of the show. Now coming up tonight on SABC3 is the second episode of Tropica Island of Treasure Curacao. So after the break, we're making a quick and delicious Tropica citrus cooler. That's perfect to sip on during tonight's show. So stay right there. More goodness, more deliciousness, more flavor coming up after the break. See you right there.